Well, while that project is moving forward, we know there are many more everyday problems that you drive through, over, and around all the time.
You might be wondering why it took so long to patch a pothole on your street, or whether a bridge that you always use is really as safe as it should be. Well, we hear these kinds of concerns all the time, and now 5 Eyewitness News is focused on getting you real answers.
Steve Tellier has worked for months now preparing for our new series, Rebuilding Minnesota, digging for ways to make Minnesota's transportation system work for you. And it sounds like there's a lot of work to be done.
It's a very, very complex issue, but we're excited about trying to dive into some of these issues. So we know many Minnesotans believe the transportation system here is not working as well as it should be, and we're making it our mission to find out why. From highways to side streets and light rail to traffic lights, we believe there has to be a better, safer, and cheaper way for you to get where you want to go, and we're going to find it. Infrastructure, the underlying foundation or basic framework. When it's working well, you barely know it's there. When it's not working well,
my thought was like, oh God, you know, here we go again.
In September, the outer lanes of the Kellogg Boulevard Bridge in downtown St. Paul were shut down. Cracks were found in the bridge's supports. The latest inspection report rated its substructure a 3. By definition, that means part of it could fall apart.
That means I'm not taking that bridge. I'll take another bridge.
And for Christopher Cunningham, it is a microcosm of Minnesota's transportation woes.
The warranties are running out on a lot of the country's infrastructure, and you know, we can't keep kicking the can down the road all the time.
And that can is being kicked down an increasingly cracked and crumbling road. We spent weeks poring over research, dissecting the data, and working our sources. We discovered there is a lot of road work ahead. Half of Minnesota's highway pavement and 35% of highway bridges are more than 50 years old. There are more than 1,000 bridges in our state that are considered structurally deficient and either need to be repaired or replaced. MnDOT itself recently ranked Minnesota 35th out of 50 states in terms of how smooth the ride is on our highways. And highway congestion in the Twin Cities is near its historic peak, with more than 1 in 5 freeway miles jammed on a typical weekday. It is so much fun.
It's getting old and it's falling apart.
The cost is going up and the resources are going down.
It's not going away, it's going to get worse.
We tapped into a team of transportation experts. L. Tinklenberg, a former MnDOT commissioner, gives Minnesota's infrastructure a grade of D.
We can't keep deluding ourselves that this is something that's just going to take care of itself.
If you don't put oil in your car, you're going to have big trouble down the road, and our road system is the same.
Kathy Quick, a professor at the University of Minnesota, specializes in getting government and the general public to sit down together and solve their transportation problems.
Cities and counties and townships as well are feeling especially pressed right now for resources.
It has a huge impact on jobs and the economy. It's also a safety issue.
Margaret Donahoe leads a group committed to making Minnesota's transportation system safer and more effective.
The problem is funding. It's that simple.
Americans are driving less, and the gas tax has barely budged in recent years, while construction costs have climbed. The result? MnDOT says Minnesota will have $30 billion in transportation needs over the next 20 years and only $18 billion to spend. That's a gaping funding gap of $12 billion. Within a decade, quote, assets will continue to decline faster than they can be repaired or replaced. Do you think we'll see more Kellogg Boulevard bridges over the next few years?
Absolutely. As the system gets older, we will see more of those.
So how do we stop that from happening? Where does the money come from? A higher gas tax? Sales tax? Tolls? Registration fees? Can we just be smarter with the money we already have?
It's just physics. Things fall apart.
The question is, how do you put them back together?
Well, it's not going to fix itself for free.
We will be investigating everything from bridge safety to state spending to the traffic lights in your neighborhood, and we want to hear from you. What are your biggest transportation concerns? What's holding up traffic near you? Do you think there's money being wasted that could possibly be better spent elsewhere?
All right, I think a lot of people would like to see that. Maybe not spend as much, just see it spent better.
Right. And we want to hear the questions from the public because we know they have a lot of them.
All right. I know you've got more coming up on Sunday, but right now you're also going to be doing a bit of web chat. I want to tell people about that. It's a series we're doing here. It is called Rebuilding Minnesota. We've set up a new section of KSTP.com, and there is a link where you can email us your tips. And in just a minute, as Steve heads back to the newsroom, we're going to have a live web chat. You can find it by going to quick links on our homepage. So log in, let us know, let Steve know what you want us to dig into.